Hey, what's up, guys? Happy Homebrew Wednesday. It's August 21st. Not a ton of stuff going on, but I'm going to try to make this one short and sweet. As you guys saw in my last video, I had a big, gigantic hole cut into our kitchen wall upstairs to kind of open up the area. So because of that and having to be here just to help the guys answer any questions and then also move some of the electrical around, I wasn't able to brew this weekend, so it's pushing my plans back. So I'm thinking I might have to cut out my a beer this year, and I think it's going to be my pumpkin, because if I've got to cut something out of like the five or six beers I'm talking about, the one I definitely can't cut out is the one my wife wants, so that's out. So actually, you know, let's delve right into that. My wife wants me to make her a cranberry beer, so I'm thinking, and what she was saying she wants me to do is add a little bit of cranberry at the end of the boil, and then add like 2 pounds worth in the secondary. So I was wondering to the people, especially in the SJ Port competition, anybody who put fruit or basically any kind of food into their beer in the secondary, how did you do it? Did you liquefy it at all? My thought is I might actually just put a little water in there at maybe add a smidge of sugar? I don't know. I haven't decided yet if I'll add any sugar. Maybe just add like a little bit of water, bring that to a boil with the cranberries in there, throw like an immersion blender in there, blend it all up so it's like a liquid, and then put that into the secondary. And the main reason I would do that is, one, it'd be easier to blend, or one, it'd be easier to boil, and two, since it's so easy to boil, it's easier to sanitize. Just boil it and be done. So that's my thought. Second thing that's going on, and I'm going to have to do it a smidge off camera, is this is my Tongue Thrasher IPA. Some of my early subscribers, or anyone who's gone back and watched some of my old videos, you would know this is like one of the first videos that, or one of the first beers that I like recorded doing. It was right after I got my burner. It was like a disaster, clusterfuck. I'm not going to go into it, but if you want to watch one of my earlier videos, or actually check the link below, I'll post the video down below, or the link to the video, so you guys can watch it, but get the whole backstory on it. But it's an intense beer. It is without a doubt a double IPA. It's intense. So I haven't had one in a while, just because I was letting it kind of smooth out. So I figured this would be a good time to do a review of it. So, and I got the boot here in case I need it, so hopefully it won't be that intense. So, bottoms up. Well, first things first, as you can see, I popped it. There's definitely carbonation from the sound, but no bottle bomb. So that is a plus. Alright, as you can see, I put a ton of hops in this bad boy. And, I think that really helped with the, oh my gosh, there is definitely, I don't know if you guys can see it because it's dark in here, but there is definitely like a green tint to the body. But you know, it is cleaned up. It's really cleared up for an IPA. But yeah, look at that head. Oh man, was that even did I lift it all the way out of the frame? So you didn't see any of it. But yeah, so it looks pretty nice. Let's go for the smell. Oh wow. There is a ton of character in this smell. Definitely picking up on the two row that was in there. You can definitely smell the two row. A little bit of the caramel. Oh, it's like over the top on the hops. There is a lot of flavor coming from those hops. So, let's give it a whirl. That is delightful. That is something that I am really glad that I decided to let age, because in the beginning, it was very bitter, and there was not a ton of, there was not a ton of character to this beer at all. It was just like, bam, punch you in the mouth, Tongue Thrasher IPA, Because I believe I used about 14 ounces of hops in this thing. There are a ton of hops. None, and no torpedoing, no dry hopping. Just all in the boil. And you know, it's like exactly what I wanted. There's a little bit of sweetness in there from the... I think I used honey malt. There's a little bit of sweetness in there. And then there's just a ton of complexity from the hops. You know, I think I had some Cascade in there. I had like some Centennial, some Columbus, I think some Citra. There's just a ton of different hop characteristics. And you know, it's kind of like the biggest fear whenever you're cooking something, if you're going to add a bunch of different spices, is that it's just too much. It's like a sensory overload. But I think this is like the perfect, just the perfect level. Oh, man. This is money. I am so glad that I waited on this beer. I mean, this thing's basically about 8 months old. You know, I think I brewed it in early January, so... You know, it's 8 months old. But man, this is good. Damn, is this good. I'm glad I brewed this thing. So, yep, enough about that. What else is going on this Homebrew Wednesday? I got a package from Justin Elder. It's the, he sent me some, what is it? Some pepper dust, or pepper powder, pepper dust. And then he sent me some seeds. So, Justin, I owe you big time, brother. I will be sending you some beers very shortly. I have my SJ Poor beer, which I'm going to send you. And the other, I think, is going to be my Hopeful Pale Ale. It'll be the first one to use the beer gun on. So it'd be a good experiment seeing if it makes its way to you safe and sound. But I do have a question, my man. The powder... you just put like an M on one and I think like a G or a D on the other. Can you just comment below or PM me by, you know, going that way and all that craziness. Let me know which is which because I want to be accurate in your reviews. But dude, thank you so much. I cannot wait until around like December and February. I'm going to start those peppers indoors under my grow light. And I want those things to just be banging huge. That way, when, you know, the frost date is passed, they're big monsters, I can put them outside, and they can just destroy and just grow a ridiculous amount of hops, a ridiculous amount of peppers. So, thank you, my man. If you could comment, though, and let me know what's what, I'd happily do it. Also, if you have any ideas of how I should taste them, I was literally just thinking, you know, put my finger in there and go to town. But that's that. And then the last thing for this Homebrew Wednesday is I have joined Untappd. Thanks to Kevin Clements and somebody else. I can't remember. Someone on Facebook. Maybe it was you, Jay Elder. So I'm on Untappd, guys. My name is the same as this, PatsFan1284. But also you can find me by my name, Joe Belcher, B-E-L-C-H-E-R. Like the guy at Ellis Island had a cruel joke. So that's basically it for me. Hope everyone else is having a great Wednesday. Hope everyone else is enjoying a beer. And that's it, guys. Short and sweet, or as short and sweet as I can do. So peace, chicken grease, enjoy your homebrews, boys and girls.